Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. I'm excited to have you back. Again, my name is Darin, and in today's post-processing tutorial, I'm going to show you how to take full control of your background in Lightroom Classic, how to change the colors, and how to make some small adjustments using the AI-powered masking, selective editing, exposure adjustments, all without ever leaving Lightroom Classic. In this video, as you see on the screen, I'm working with Darin. Darin is a local model that I work with a lot in the studio in Manhattan, Kansas. So shout out to Darin. She's always bringing great energy to the set, and you'll see that vibe come through in today's image. We'll use this image of Darin to walk through every step-by-step from creating a clean background mask to adjusting the exposure and color temperature, and even redefining the edges using the add and subtract masking tools. Let's start with a quick tour. In Lightroom Classic, we're working in development mode. At the top right-hand corner, right beside the library section, you see development. In the development mode, over here to the right, you'll have a little panel. That panel has in it six different options. You have the edit tab, crop overlay tab, remove spot healing tab, red eye correction tab, the masking tab, and also the AI editing status tab. We're going to use the masking tab. So let's go ahead and click on that. We're in development mode, masking tab, and we're going to create a mask. Now you can do subject, the sky background. Today we're going to do background. So let's go ahead and click background. Lightroom is going to automatically select the background that's best using the AI functions, and sometimes it's going to have some overage of the masking, and sometimes it's going to have, it's not going to grab everything. So we're going to go over how to use the add and subtract function. Right here you got the mask. You can turn the mask on and off just to see where it has selected. So right now, we see that right here, we're gonna have to subtract this to take this away because we don't wanna change this. And we got some right down here, and then we could add some here and here. So let's go to subtract. We're gonna go to object. You can either use object or brush. I use object a lot. So we're gonna go over here, gonna zoom in a little bit, and you see that we can make this bigger or smaller. We're gonna subtract this away from it. There we go. And then I'm gonna press on the space bar, grab this, pull this up. We're gonna have to do this again, subtract object. And we wanna take this away. There we go, do it one more time. Take some of this away. All right, we're going to back out. There we go. And now we have subtracted those two spots. If we turn this on and off, you will see it. And so now we're just going to add. We're going to add object, and then we're just going to add it right here and right here. We're going to zoom in a little bit, pull this down, and then we're going to add right here. So let's go to add object, make this a little smaller. There we go. More. We just got to get used to this. Keep coming in here and playing around with different functions. We're going to do just a little small. It's your preference if you want to go this deep. There we go. We'll come here, click back. It's going to zoom out automatically. We're going to go back to the mask. And there we go. So now we're going to come over here. And if you're ever shooting in the studio, and shoot on a white background and somehow the light doesn't hit that background enough to brighten it up the way you want it, this is how you're going to make your background pure white or whiter. So we can go ahead to the exposure tab. We're gonna just bring this up about 50 to 75. And if you see, I'm gonna go ahead and turn the mask on and off. You see how bright within seconds. So that's what I do sometimes. I don't really worry about exposing the background as much as I can. If I can use multiple lights, I do. If not, I know I can brighten the background later. I just try to expose for the model as much as I can. All right, so now that we got the background, we got the exposure, you even can use whites. Whites will definitely change that. I don't use whites too much, but adjust exposure. So now we know how to illuminate or make the background wider. So now we're gonna change the color. I know from past experience that the brighter the background is, the difficult it is to change the color of the background. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna reduce the background to probably about a -1.550 in exposure. I'm gonna bring this white back down. So we just want the background to be a little gray. Now, if you want the background gray, this is how to do it also. Of course, here you see we got some space right here. If you make it darker, you will see more imperfections. But again, you can go and let's add just to make sure we cover those spots. Zoom in a little bit. Let's add right here. You don't want to be too close near her clothes. There we go. Maybe add one more. Everything is based on your preference. And then let's add object. We're gonna come over here, zoom in. Hit that space bar to grab the photo to bring it up or down. And then we're gonna try to gray out this area about a couple of inches away from, and look at there. All right, so go back out, click on the photo. It's gonna automatically zoom back out. Go back to the mask, and here we go. So now that's great. So now in order to change the color, we're gonna come over here to our panel. And we're gonna see temperature. We slide it from blue, it changes to blue. We slide it to the right, to the yellow, it's gonna make it a little cream, a tan color. And then if we turn it the tint, it's gonna be green, tint's gonna be purple. So we can go down to hue, and hue changes it automatically to the AI preference. And the saturation. I really like to come down here to the color section, and we're going to click on the no color effect, and you can automatically, with the paint dropper, you can just automatically change it to a color that you want to. This is pretty cool. I am normally in a white and gray background, so more editorial is basically my preference, a little tan there. But let's click out of here. We go and just that quick. Now, of course, you would have to come back in here and make some small adjustments. You would have to edit some of her hair, but you know, we can do that in Photoshop. But I just wanted to show you how to go to the development tool, how to create a mask, how to add and subtract some of the edges to make sure you capture it all, and how to use the color section with the temperature, the tint, the hue, the saturation, and even use the no color effect tab. So in closing, that's how you mask, redefine, transform, and change the color in the background in Lightroom Classic. So I appreciate y'all coming and tuning in. I appreciate y'all for supporting me. But before you leave, drop a comment. Let me know how I did. If you want me to go over any more changes, I can also do this in Photoshop. I will be doing a tutorial for that. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell for more photography tips from my studio. And lastly, love, peace, and photos.